to my brand new Art Attack monster video. Now, I've got loads of monstrous things lined up for you to make. Some are friendly. Look at that. That one was a pet. And some are not so friendly. You wouldn't want it as a pet. Now, there are some monsters that you can make to spook other people, and some you can make to spook yourself. If you don't want to make a monster, then there are also some great ideas how to draw them. Whatever type of monster you're after, they're always great fun to do. But first, let's start with one of my favourite big art attacks, where I come face to face with a very, very old monster. Take a look at this.
Egyptian mummy stuff.
Yeah, gives me an idea for a big art attack. Horrible, isn't it? And whatever it is, it's coming through the wall to get you. to make your own monster coming at you through his wall, see that little bit of the wall there? Then you need to draw and cut out a big oval piece of cardboard box card. Then you need to get some white paper and just tear it into rough triangle shapes, just very rough triangle shapes. Now you need to do quite a few of these, and they don't need to be exactly the same. Some can be thinner and longer, and you need to do the same thing with some cardboard box card. Again, tear or cut some rough long triangles like that. And if you do cut them, make sure you rough up the edges by tearing them. And again, you need to make loads of these. Then take some glue and put some glue around the outside edge of your cardboard oval, and then stick on a card triangle so that the point faces inwards like that. See that point facing inwards? And then place another one next to it. Again, stick that down, point facing inwards. And it doesn't matter if the outside edge here is a bit messy. Just keep gluing and sticking on more torn corner triangles, one next to each other, like that. Then put some more glue on the top of these card triangles. And yes, you've guessed it. This time, take your paper triangles and just stick them on the top, again with the points facing inwards. And just keep putting on more paper triangles on top of the cardboard triangles like that. And if you go all the way around the oval in the same way, gluing card first and paper on top, if you let the glue dry, you'll have something that looks like this. See that? All your strips there. So now you need to scrunch and bend the triangles back. Now the paper ones first, so give them a scrunch. And just bend them back like this. And this gives the effect of torn wallpaper that your monster is bursting through. And then do those card triangles. Just bend them back and do all the triangles in the same way. And you'll have something that looks like this. See that? And this is the hole in the wall. And there's your wallpaper all bent back. Now you're ready to put the monster in it coming at you. So start with the monster's face. Just use a scrunched up sheet of newspaper for the top part of the head like that, and just tape that into place. Then scrunch up another sheet of newspaper, this time slightly tighter, so it's slightly smaller, and tape it underneath the top of that head like that, and this will be the bottom jaw. Then roll up sheet of newspaper lengthways and just bend it round like that and tape that into place. And you can use loads of tape for this, make it nice and strong. And you can add more newspaper features if you want, just by scrunching bits of newspaper up. How about two scrunched up newspaper eyes there with tape on, and some rolls of newspaper for eyebrows, just pushing them down in the middle to make them look nice and angry. Looks funny, doesn't it? And it needs some sharp teeth, so how's about cutting some little triangles, cardboard box card, so one in there, and you can work out where you want to put all these different bits. I'll just put one in there to show you, like that. You can even add in some card horns. I'll put those on the top of his head, like that. And that's your monster's face looking at you. Next, you need to make two monster hands. Now, for each hand, start by scrunching up a squarish shaped ball of newspaper, and that will be the monster's hand, nice and big and chunky. Then roll up some tubes of newspaper and just cut them to size like I've done with these, and these will be your monster's fingers. Now, as it's a monster, you've got 3, 4, or 5 fingers. I'm going to do 4 fingers and a thumb there. And the idea is to tape the fingers over the top of the hand like that. And if you do them all in the same way, you'll have a fantastic paper hand. Look at that, all the fingers on the top of the hand there, like that. If you do another one in the same way, you'll have another hand, and you could even add on some cardboard claws. Just take them into place, like that. Then put the hands in position near the bottom of the face, so that it looks like your monster is bursting out at you. Just fit them in there like that. And you need to use lots of tape to keep them in place. And when it's all taped up, you'll have something that looks like this. Look at that. And you see, I've taped the hands, and I've taped the head, and everything is really secure in there. I think it's beginning to look quite spooky already. Then, to give your monster his skin, mix some PVA glue in equal parts with water and just paste it onto your monster. Just slop it on like that. And the idea is to lay on strips of kitchen roll. And again, just paste some more glue over the top of that. And just use your brush to push the kitchen roll down into all those nooks and crannies. And again, do the hands in exactly the same way. Just paste glue onto each finger. And fiddly, but just wrap your kitchen roll around your finger like that. And just push it into place with your brush again, covering it in a bit more glue. And the idea is to cover the face and hands in two layers of tissue and glue. And when you've done the whole thing, leave it to dry, you'll have something that looks like that. Look at that, see what's happened here? The tissue has dried and covered your monster in wrinkled skin. And now he's ready to paint. Now, it's a good idea to paint black all the way around your monster onto the backing card down there to create a black hole. See that? And to do this, you might need to just hold the card and paper back. Try not to get any paint onto the card or paper. Doing this black gives the illusion as if he's coming out of a deep black hole. And when it comes to the monster itself, you can do him any colour you like, but you know, real gruesome colours work very well, like a gruesome green. The idea is to just slap it all over it, and you can even mix in some slightly darker shades, but black in there, to give the skin sort of monstery texture. And you paint the hands green as well. Again, just blending different shades of green together, maybe streaking in some black or brown. And his eyes has about a really fierce red. It's very bloodshot, doesn't it? It just looks like blood. And when you finish painting the whole thing, he looks like this. Look at that. And I've done his teeth a sort of yellowy white, and I've added a white highlight onto his eyes there, like a fierce sparkle. And if you tape some string onto the back, using some nice strong tape there, piece of string, you can hang him up on your bedroom wall and scare yourself stiff. And he looks as though he's bursting through the wall, coming at you. And you can make any design you like. Here's another monster coming at you, made in exactly the same way, using newspaper to make the shape of a skull in the hands. Or how about this? A kind of alien coming at you. This one's got three paper eyes stuck out on newspaper stalks. And you know, if you don't want to make a full monster, how about one that's peeping through a slit? Try it yourself. Monsters coming at you through the walls. Brilliant, aren't they? Of course, monsters come in all shapes and sizes. Some are nice, some are nasty. But you know what? Some can actually be quite useful. Take a look at this chap. He's an angry door knocker. G'day. If you're fed up with people bursting through your bedroom door without knocking, then this is the monster that you need. Take a piece of cardboard box card and start by drawing an angry mouth. Now, it can be any shape you like, but just make sure it's angry. And you must make the lips just over 1 centimetre thick, like that. And then cut it out there and then. The best way to do that is pop a pencil through the middle to get your scissors in, and you'll have something that looks like that. And that will be the knocker device. And then place that onto a bigger piece of cardboard box card and just draw around it like that, and then using this as a guide, just draw in the rest of your face. Now, don't forget to make it really angry, a sort of gruesome gargoyle, get really ugly like that. And when it comes to drawing in the shape of your face, make sure the chin when you've done your face, it's very important to just draw two dots at the top of the top lip and two dots just below the top lip, not too far apart. Then stick a sharp pencil through those. Be very careful doing that to make holes in them. Cut the whole thing out and you'll have something that looks like that. And there it is, that's your goggles face. Now to thicken up the knocker device or handle, take a sheet of newspaper and roll it or scrunch it up into a stitch like that. And then just give it a twist and wrap it around one side of those cardboard lips like that. Tape that into place and then do the same on both sides using plenty of tape so it's nicely rounded and thick. And then take a rounded pebble or stone, a small pebble or stone, and just place that on the bottom lip and just tape that into position by taping it just around the outside edge of the pebble. Don't go over the top of the pebble. And use plenty of strong tape. Now to make it really secure, mix some PVA glue in equal parts with water, the good old white school glue you get in squidgy bottles. Paste that onto your cardboard and paper lips and just put on some strips of kitchen roll or tissue paper or loo roll, wrap them around the lips into the glue like that, press them into place with the glue, and when it comes to the pebble, just glue around the outside edge again and put your strip of tissue paper around the edge. Don't go over that pebble, otherwise your knocker will not. Cover the whole thing in two layers of tissue paper and PVA glue mixture, and when it's gone hard, you'll have something that looks like this. See that? Rock hard, and you've got the pebble peeping out at the top. And then place that on your goggles face, line it up with the lips, and then just take another small rounded pebble or stone and just pop that onto the cardboard lips on your goggles face and place those 3D lips over the top, line up the stones so they knock, and then tape the pebble into place in the same way, PVA glue right up to the edge, two layers of it, and when that's gone hard, you have something that looks like that. Look at that, it's rock solid, and the pebble is trapped there. And then you can, if you want to, build up your goggles face into 3D ugly features. Just scrunch up a board of tissue paper into your glue mixture, squeeze out the excess, and then just place it onto your cardboard and mold it into the shape of those features. And if you do all the features in the same way and then leave them to dry, and dry, it goes rock hard and all 3D like. Look at that, really ugly. See that? But whatever you do, don't cover up those holes. If you do cover them up, just pop a pencil through them. And now it's ready to paint. Now you can paint it any colour you like, poster paint or acrylic paint, but here's a good technique. How about if you paint it all black to start with, and then scrunch up a ball of tissue paper or kitchen roll, not too tight, and dip it into a lighter coloured paint, and then just very gently brush it across the surface. You get this sort of mottled, ancient effect. Now I'm using a bronzy colour here, a light brown colour, and it makes it look all metallic. And when you've done the whole goggle face in the same way, it looks something like this. Look at that, that looks absolutely brilliant. I've even done the knocker in the same colour, and then if you turn it over, you can thread some string through those holes and tie the knocker to the goggle's head with a knot around the back, and I've even painted the string so you can't see it. And then just put some sticky tack on the back and hang it up on your bedroom door. And anyone that wants to come into your bedroom is confronted by an angry knocker. And you know, you could try different gargoyle shapes for the different rooms in your house. And of course, you can do them in any colour you like. Try it yourself, an angry gargoyle knocker. Is your room cluttered with old sweet papers, scraps of paper, and other bits of rubbish that you've left strewn all over the floor? What you need is a garbage gobbler. Come and have a look at this. And believe it or not, the whole thing is made out of old bits of newspaper. Now you need to take three small-sized newspapers and open one of them out so that the centre pages are facing up, and just with a bit of sticky tape, centre pages facing down. So the two centre pages are touching, and you've got two newspapers, one on top of the other, with all their pieces of paper taped together. Then take a stapler and just staple together all of the pages of both newspapers together down the two sides. Not the top or the bottom, just do them down the two sides. If you haven't got a stapler, try and borrow one. Maybe you could take it to school and do it at school. You can use tape for this, but it's a lot stronger if you use a stapler. And do us a favour, if you're doing any stapling, watch your fingers. It's better still. Get someone else to do it. And when the two sides are really secure, nicely stapled together, lift the whole thing up and stand it up by opening out the two newspapers like that, so you have a sort of box shape. And then take your third newspaper and just loosely place it on the top like that. And notice it's too big, it doesn't fit. You've got this overhanging edge. Well, just fold that over and just tape it into place. It's a bit tricky to do, so you might need to get someone to hold the newspaper underneath for you. And put loads of tape on. I'm just doing one bit to show you. Tape the overhang over all the way around, really securely, loads of tape. So when you've done it, it looks like this. And look at this. Hey presto, no overhang. Tape all those bits together, nicely secure. And then flip it over, and there you have a bin shape. Well, let's face it, bins are boring. We want a garbage gobbler. And to make the garbage gobbler, you need to make a mouth and some eyes. Now, to make the mouth, scrunch up about six sheets of newspaper into a sort of sausage shape, and just tape the sausage both ends. Again, I'm doing this really quickly. I always do on an art attack, don't I? I have to do it really quickly to show you, but you can take a lot more time over this. Take that sausage in place like this, and then make another sausage out of six sheets of newspaper again, and just overlap the two of them together, and tape the two of them together right in the middle, like that. So, in actual fact, you have a very long sausage. And the idea is to curl that into the top rim, or the top edge of your bin shape. And just curl it all the way around, and you notice where it overlaps, just there, hold it in place, and tape the overlap together. And then the tricky bit. Just fold the top rim of the bin shape around that mouth, or around that lip. That's what it is, it's a garbage gobbler's lips. And tape it as you're going, tape it into place securely. Quite tricky to do, so take some time doing it. And when you've taped it in place, you'll have something that looks like that. See that? The garbage gobbler's lip is nicely folded in the top rim and taped securely in place. And to make the eyes, scrunch up two balls of newspaper. You need about three sheets of newspaper for each ball. And just tape them securely to that top edge. And to make the whole thing a lot more secure, mix some PVA glue, two parts glue, one part water, and you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to slop it on all over my garbage gobbler, and just pop on some kitchen roll for this one. Kitchen roll is nice and strong. You can use tissue paper or loo roll. You might have to do two layers of it. Just slap the glue on, and you cover the eyes, you cover the lips, and the bottom and the sides of your garbage gobbler. You can even fold it slightly down into the mouth, but don't put all the way down inside the mouth. Waste your time. And then when you've done the whole garbage gobbler, you'll have something that looks like this. And you know what I usually say at this stage? I usually say, leave it to dry overnight. And shock horror, don't leave it to dry overnight. It's at this stage, whilst it's still damp, that you just pull down that top rim to create the mouth of the garbage gobbler. You just want it pulled down on one side. Because it's still wet, you can crunch it down. And see that? The eyes come down to one side as well. And then leave it to one side to dry. And when it's dry, very important, you wait for it to dry, paint it up. Paint it garbage gobbler colour. Don't ask me what garbage gobbler colour is. Use it poster paint or acrylic paint. Maybe a nice green or a yucca purple or something. And this one isn't quite dry yet, but I'm still going to paint on it just to show you. Just slop the paint on, and you can design your own garbage bobbler. And when you've painted the whole thing, you'll have something that looks like this. There it is. And see what I've done here? I've painted it green, I've given purple lips, and I've given a red mouth inside, and I've put in some detail with a marker pen on the eyes. And then you just pop him or her under your desk, next to your bed, or better still, on the other side of your room, so that then it's great fun to try and throw the rubbish in. Yes, I've been practicing that all day. And you could even try this. You cut out a cardboard tongue and pad it out with some newspaper and some hands and feet, and take them to your garbage gobbler before you cover it with kitchen roll and paint it up. It looks like that. Brilliant, isn't it? Try it yourself. Gobble your garbage with a garbage gobbler. Trying to invent your own weird and wonderful creatures. Now, if you fancy doing a bit of drawing, here's some ideas for you. Why not have a go at turning ordinary things into gruesome pictures? Now, it can work with anything or anyone. How about starting with yourself? Start by drawing a very simple picture of yourself, like this one I've done. It doesn't need to be brilliant or anything. Or you could always trace a picture of someone else from a magazine and then simply turn it into an alien by altering all the features. Just make it up as you go along. Take each feature on your face and do something really horrible with it. Now I'm going to start with my eyes here. And I'm going to make them really sticky out and bulbous. It looks really horrible. We have some great fun doing this. And instead of giving myself two eyelids, each eye, I'm going to give myself four eyelids. And maybe you don't have eyebrows. Maybe they're just like bony plates. Go up like this. Just make it as gruesome as you can. What about my nose? I know. I want to make it all wrinkly and crinkly like that. Maybe with huge nostrils. Quite spooky. And my mouth, instead of two lips, let's give me four lips. And as for my teeth, well, I think I'll give myself fangs, pointed teeth, like that. And what about my ears? I know what I'll do. I'll give myself bat ears, so they're all wrinkly and crinkly, like a bat. The great thing about turning yourself into an alien is you just as you go along. Now I think what I'll do is I'll make my face really bony. Give me a real bony chin like that. And for the top of my head, how's about a real fat head? That looks like there's all brain bursting out inside there. Instead of hair, I think I'll give myself some scales at the top. For my skin, I think I'll make that scaly as well. Some scales in there. And I'm going to make my pupils really slanted and slitty. I'm going to make them go in the other way. See a way to slanting like that. Pretty horrible, isn't it? And I'm going to do a really long, wrinkly neck. Now, I think I'm going to start colouring bits of it in, so I think I'll do my eyes in real alien red. And my skin, I think I'll make it a Martian-y green colour. Martians really green? And do they really exist? How's a Martian be green? And then just rub out a few of those little pencil lines there that are showing. And there it is. There's me as an alien. What do you mean it's an improvement? Try it yourself. Turn yourself or someone else into an alien. Now, when it comes to monsters, you can get inspiration from just about anywhere. Your own imagination, comics, books, TV and films. I mean, have you ever seen those Hollywood movies with gremlins? Great gremlins, all shapes and sizes, but all of them little monsters. Well, why not create one of your own? Ooh, horrible, isn't it? Here's how to make one. Now, believe it or not, the gremlin himself is made up completely from rolled up or scrunched up newspaper. It's sort of newspaper sculpture. And the great thing is, you can create any shaped little monster you like. Now for your gremlin's head, just scrunch up a couple of sheets of newspaper. Now you need to scrunch them into a ball about the size of a tennis ball, and then just tape it into shape. It doesn't need to be perfect or anything. And you can put on plenty of tape. As usual, I haven't got time and heart attack to do all of that, so I'm just doing a couple of bits to show you to hold it together like that. Now you can even poke a pencil into the paper to create two eye holes, or maybe even three, depending on what you want your monster to look like. There's one in there, be careful when you're doing this, one in there, and maybe even a mouth to make it really gruesome and open that paper out. Now make the body much bigger by scrunching up even more sheets of newspaper. And you'll notice I've made this one slightly squarer. You can do it in the shape you like, actually. And again, put plenty of tie the gremlin's arms, roll a couple of sheets of newspaper into a tube, and fold it in half like that. Tape those two ends together firmly, and then make two in exactly the same way, like that. Then to make your gremlin look really scary, put it into a monster position, like that. Bend the arms, bend them on there, and on there, and tape them onto the body, just behind the head, so that they bend over like that. So it looks like he's coming at you in a spooky way. See that one on there, like that, and then bend that one over there. And the piece of tape again, use plenty of tape for this. Now, to make the legs and tail, do it in exactly the same way. Roll up sheets of newspaper, and again, this time I've used even more sheets to make the legs slightly thicker, and I've even rolled back one here, a little bit at the end for the feet, and put plenty of tape onto it to hold it together. And there it is, there's a leg, and tape them into position on the body. And again, you know what I'm gonna say, use plenty of tape. So there's one on there like that. He gets into all the positions here. Put him there. And another piece of tape on the other side like that. And then the great thing about these newspaper sculptures is you can keep altering the position and taping it into place. And then just finally up the back, the tail. And I just put that on the back there, like that. And when you're happy with the position of everything, again, put plenty of tape on to make it nice and strong, and tape it onto some cardboard box card for a base. There it is. And again, use plenty of tape, and you can see why I've made the legs and the tail thicker, so that they support the body and keep it standing up. Then take another piece of cardboard box card and draw on some monster bits. Now you can do anything you like. I'm going to do some bat wings. Here's a good way of doing bat wings. Watch this. Up, down, one, two, three. Do it again. It goes up, down, one, two, three. There it is. Cut them out and tape them to your gremlin. I'm just going to put them in position on the back there like that. Hold them like that, and again use plenty of tape. And again, I'm just going to do it very quickly to show you there like that. And to make it even more gruesome, I've cut out and stuck on some cardboard horns and some claws, and there's some claws down there on his feet, not that. And I've even cut the base to a sort of yucky splat shape. Now, to give your gremlin a really tough, hard skin, mix some PVA glue in equal parts with water and just slop it onto your gremlin. And yeah, you know the form by now. Just paste on your glue and wrap some tissue paper or loo roll or kitchen roll around your gremlin. Just paste in more glue on as you go. And don't forget to push it around all the shapes and into all of those nooks and crannies. I'll just put another one on there to show you. And the idea is to cover the whole thing in two layers of your PVA glue mixture and tissue paper, getting into all of those shapes. When you've done it, leave it to dry. And when it's dry, it's gone absolutely rock hard. Rock hard. And the skin has got all of these horrible wrinkles and lumps and bumps. See that? Perfect gremlin skin. Then paint it any design you like. Now I'm going to do mine in a gruesome green to start with. So you can just slop on your base colour there like that. And get that sort of swampy green going. And then into that you could mix in streaks. Other mushy colours. How's about some boggy brown? Like that. Just sort of bog gremlin this way. Just streak that in. See the way it's all streaking in and giving the effect some sort of marsh monster or something. And we could even put in some, I don't know, pus yellow. Blech. Mix all of that in there. It all helps your sort of monster's skin. When it's all done, leave it to dry. When it's dry, could paint on some more detail. Let's see what we've got here. Well, I've put on some fangs, some white fangs, dripping in blood. Look at that, oozing in blood. And these really sinister yellow eyes. I've even painted on some warts on his claws here. He's got some more blood. And there it is, there's your gremlin. And what do gremlins do? Scare people. So, place it somewhere in your house so that it's lurking in a dark corner, waiting to give someone the fright of their lives. And you can make any gremlin design you like, and you can make them as cute as you like, or as gruesome as you like. Try it yourself, a gruesome gremlin. Great time on that film set making Frankenstein. Well, that's nearly it. But here's one final messy Art Attack monster that's really friendly and really easy to make. Hey, come here. Can I ask you a personal question. What lives under your bed? Or in the bottom of your wardrobe? Smelly socks? Old food? Something horrible? Grimy? I'll show you what lives under mine. Splat monsters. Good, aren't they? Look at that one. Cute in a splatty sort of way. Do you know what? They're very easy to make and great fun to do. Come and have a look at this. Now, to make a splat monster, first you need to lay down a bin bag or plastic carrier bag to protect the surface that you're working on. Then you need to make some paper pulp. Now, to do this, mix some PVA glue with a small amount of water, but you need quite a lot of this mixture. Then, this is the boring bit, tear up about 6 double pages of newspaper into little bits. Might take you some time. Get Granny to do it or something. And when you've done all that, you have all of this. Look at that. Then, I'm going to do something you hardly ever see me do on Art Attack. I'm going to roll up my sleeves because this is messy. The idea is to put your paper bits, there we go, into the glue and squelch them about with your hands. Oh, I love my job. Look at that. Keep squelching and slowly, very slowly, the paper will soak up the glue and it will start to disintegrate as you keep mushing about. Now, look, I have to say, this takes a bit of time. It's great fun to do, but when it's done, wipe your hands and you will have something that looks like this. Look at that. Looks horrible, doesn't it? It looks like the moon's surface. Well, it makes your monster's body. So just grab a handful of it, like that, and then mould it into a rough ball. Again, just squidging, squelching, and moulding. And then hold this just above your bin bag and let it drop. There we go. Then you just mould it into shape a little bit if you need to. That's not bad actually, so I think we're going to leave that like that. Just push the sides down a bit so your splat monster's got a flat bottom. Now, to make the splats coming out of the monster's body, use smaller bits of newspaper pulp. Just grab them and sort of roll them into splat arm shapes, whatever that is, sort of sausages, really, and just place it on the bag so that it's next to your monster's body and mould it into shape like that and just gradually smooth it in like that. Look at that. It's all in the fingerwork on this one. I'll do another one there to show you. Oh yeah, I've got the sausage and I'll just put it on there like that and press that into the bag. So just smooth around the edges of the splat until you're happy with its shape. And you need to do splats all the way around. I'm just going to do this couple to show you. Now, to make your monster's eyes, just use even smaller bits of pulp and just mould them into little balls and stick them in place on the top of the body. And that's just pressing down a bit, don't want to squash them there. Now, for his mouth, take a pencil and just carefully push it into the body at the front, just under the eyes, and wiggle it about a bit to create a nice toothless grin. See that? And when you've done this, and all the splats around the bottom, leave it to dry. Now, it will take quite a long time to dry, but it's worth it, because when it's dry, you'll have something that looks like that. Look at that. Brilliant, isn't it? And look at that. He's got all rock hard. He's really solid. And to give your monster his gloopy skin, you need to get some different coloured poster paints. And the idea is to pour your first colour over the monster and let the paint drip. So here we go. Whoa, look at that lot. On you go. There it goes. Let it all drip down to create this gloopy, splatty sort of effect. And then do the same with your second colour. I'm going to use a yellow here. So watch this all mix in. Oh, down it goes. Look at that. Over there. Very nice. And do the same again with your third colour. And I love doing messy art attacks like this. As long as you prepare for them first. Don't make too much mess. Great fun. Look at that. And leave that to dry, but I'm just going to lift it up a little bit there to see the effect. There he is, look at that. You can see him in there. And you can always touch up those little bits there with a paintbrush. And you know, you can get different effects for your monster. to skin depending on the different colours that you use. Okay, let's try another one this time, just because I like doing it. There we go, here's a yellow one. Let's see what happens to this one. There it goes there. I'm just going to pour this. Actually, I'm going to do it quicker this time, see what happens. There it goes. And then an orange one. I'm going to do it in sort of hoops around there, like that. And again, any of those bits that you miss, any of those gaps, you can touch them up with a paintbrush, but try not to spoil the gloopy effect. And finally, I'm going to have a purple on this one. Yes, right, that looks beginning to take over there, not too much. All dribbling down like that. And how about finally, maybe one using fluorescent colours. Again, I'm going to start off with a sort of fluorescent yellow around there. See what I'm doing? I'm pouring out onto all those splatty arms. And try it with the pink, fluorescent pink. And over the arms again there. Like that. Again, if you miss any of the bits out, just pour over them. There's another bit. And finally, maybe a fluorescent orange down. Oh, look at that. That's really going for it, isn't it? And there. There, and again with a good old paintbrush, touch up any of those bits that you've actually missed. But again, trying not to spoil that sort of gloopy, pourry effect. And when you've left it to dry, it'll look really bad. I'm just going to lift it up just to show you the effect. See that? That's really splatty, isn't it? Look at that. That's fantastic. And when you've done all of this and the painting is dry, you can add further detail, such as white eyes, and maybe you can do the detail on his eyes in black permanent marker, and give him a black permanent marker mouth. I think that looks brilliant. And how about this? When you're at the messy, wet newspaper pulp stage, just before you paint it, you could cut some little cardboard box card arms and hands, and just stick them in at the sides like that. Look at that, just press them into your pulp, press them in nice and firmly, and when this is dried, and it's all painted, you'll have a messy little splat monster that looks like this. Look at that. He's a sort of, hello, mum, splat monster. And the great thing is, these splat monsters come out different every time. Right then, I'll just take this one to his home. And he lives under here with all of his friends. Look at that lot. Try it yourself. Make a splat monster that lurks in the murky dark areas of your bedroom. Well, there you are. I've come to the end of my Art Attack Monster video. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as I have. Now, you can use these ideas for inspiration, or you could try inventing some of your own. Well, have fun, whatever monsters you decide to create, and I'll see you next time. Ta-ra!